Hello. Nifty continues positive momentum for 6 consecutive weeks. It made a new lifetime high near to 11,760 and got stuck in a range in last 3-4 trading session. Market is continuously making a higher top higher bottom formation even after the depreciating rupee, which is near to 71 level. Looking at the sector wise, we have seen buying interest in most of the sector in last couple of weeks, especially the buying interest in IT and pharma counter because of the depreciating rupee. Looking at the inflow in Indian market, FIs bought around 995 crore worth of shares, while DIs bought around 2823 crore worth of shares in the month of August. Market has seen the strong momentum in last two series, July and August. It rallied by around 1000 points, led by the movement in heavyweights counter, especially the participation of selective IT, Reliance, Bajaj Finance, FMCG name. However, the mid cap and small cap also witnessed a bounce from lower levels in last couple of weeks. But recently, the underperformance in the post and positive momentum of the private bank is keeping a range bound move in the Nifty index as well. Looking at the bank Nifty, that has been consolidating in between 27,750 to 28,388 zone, brought a range of 500 points from last 18 trading sessions, which indicates that absence of follow up at higher levels, but again decline is being bought in the market. Looking at the database in the last month, the worry of a trade war was there between US and China. India front, we have seen India's first quarter FY19 real GDP that grew by around 8.2%, and it is the fastest in the last 9 quarter, and that is led by consumption and investment growth. Real GVA also grew by 8% on account of pickup in industrial growth, that is by 10.3%, and better agriculture growth, that is by 5.3%. So there is a good sign for the economy per se. Looking at the stock wise, TCS again reclaimed its top rank with market cap nearly 8 lakh crore. We have seen the stock space action in the market in the last week when TCS, Infi, Reliance, ITC made the recent 52 weeks high. But again, the range bound move was also visible and the adjustment fell down after its news flow of that RBI allowed presence here to continue its positions. Looking at the last week movement, the Nifty made the high near to 11,750. We have seen the volatility in the rupee and volatility in the crude price as well, that rose by around 77.5 per barrel. Now looking at the key, it will come on Wednesday, ADP non-farm, employment changes, financial services PMI, China's August month trade balance, US unemployment data. Looking at the India's, the Nikkei August manufacturing PMI, service PMI, automobile numbers. So it's a data heavy week, and as per the outcome of the data, market is likely to take cues. Overall setup is positive, but already market has seen the strong technically moment. Speaking, if it manages to respect its support, so technically speaking, the market has been respecting to its rising support trend line and supports are gradually shifting higher. However, we have seen the strong momentum of around 1000 points in last 2 months. So some pause in positive momentum could be seen, but overall, till it holds above 11,620, trend could remain intact to positive for a move towards 11,800, 11,925. While on the downside, major supports are placed at 11,500 to 450 zone. Looking at the bank Nifty also, it has got stuck in a range. It has been forming the multiple tops near to 28,333, 28,388 zone, but at the same time, it is finding buy interest near to 27,750 level. So now the bank Nifty, which has been moving between 27,750 to 28,388 zone, has to give the decisive range breakout, then only we may see a fresh leg of rally in the market. So if it breaks 27,750, then one need to be cautious. In that scenario, it may see a dip of 300 to 500 points on the lower side, while on the upside, hurdles for the bank Nifty are near to 28,128 and 28,333 to 28,388 zone. Thanks, have a great week.